Welcome, pilots! This video is part of my guide detailing every high-security combat site. In most of these videos, you'll see me flying an assault frigate called the Ishker. This is mainly because it's my favorite ship to fly, but it does perform reasonably well in the Serpentis Lookout and its escalation, Angel Kickbacks. Combat signatures appear in your probe scanner window, and you must scan them down with probes before you can warp to them. Some combat signatures do not have a difficulty rating, and instead have a chance of escalating to a short story-based expedition. The Serpentis Lookout is a combat signature found in all systems with a security status of 0.8 and lower throughout Gallente space. This site has a decent potential for either a faction spawn or an escalation, either of which may lead to high-value loot drops. You will land directly on an ancient acceleration gate, which you must activate to enter the first room of the site. The first room has three groups of Serpentis NPCs. The first group is down below near a barren asteroid and a pair of radio telescopes. This group consists of up to four frigates. The second group is above near a snake-shaped asteroid and a bunker. This group consists of three frigates and a cruiser. The third group is off in the distance, near a missile battery. This group consists of up to seven frigates. The frigate named Coreli Guardian is considered an advanced frigate, and has a particularly strong armor tank. The acceleration gate to the next room is locked, requiring that all NPCs in the area be destroyed. Defenses in the second room are split into five groups of Serpentis NPCs. The first group is on the left, near a bunker surrounded by a series of solar harvesters. This group consists of up to three destroyers. The second group is above, near a hollow asteroid. This group consists of six frigates and corvettes. The third group is off to the right, near an asteroid colony. This group consists of six frigates. The fourth group is off in the distance, near a bunker, at the center of a large elemental base. This group consists of seven frigates and destroyers. The fifth group is guarding the Serpentis Control Center, also amidst the elemental base. This group consists of two destroyers. Most of the NPCs in the room can be ignored. Taking out the destroyers by the solar harvesters has a chance of spawning a Shadow Serpentis frigate. The Shadow Serpentis NPC will always drop 1,000 rounds of either Shadow Serpentis or Guardian Small Charge Ammunition, and a Shadow Serpentis Copper Tag. If you're even more lucky, it may also drop a Shadow Serpentis Module, a Snake or Asklepian Implant, or a Single Run Blueprint Copy for a Daredevil. Destroying the Shadow Serpentis NPC has a chance of escalating to the Angel Kickbacks Expedition. As soon as you arrive, your instruments detect a large group of ships departing. Further analysis of the data indicates this was a convoy of 6 to 8 transport ships from the Salvation Angels, accompanied by an unknown number of combat vessels. Your navigation systems have already come up with a likely destination in case you feel you have any business with them. Escalations will appear on the Exploration tab of the Agency window. If no faction frigate appears, your second chance at being awarded an escalation is to destroy the Serpentis Control Center. As with all unrated expeditions, Angel Kickbacks will have you travel through up to 4 encounters. Each encounter may either continue to escalate or come to an end. The chance of either the faction spawn or the escalation is significantly higher in this site than it is for anomalies such as the Serpentis Hideaway, Refuge, or Den. For the first encounter of the Angel Kickbacks Expedition, you will land directly on an ancient acceleration gate guarded by a group of Serpentis NPCs. This group consists of up to 8 frigates and destroyers. There is a reasonable chance that one of them will be a Shadow Serpentis frigate. This, and any other Shadow Serpentis NPC in future Angel Kickbacks encounters, may drop a Shadow Serpentis module, a Snake or Asklepian Implant, or a Single Run Blueprint Copy for a Daredevil. Destroying the Shadow Serpentis NPC has a chance of escalating to the second encounter of the Angel Kickbacks Expedition. Not much here except this empty warehouse. Perhaps the next location will reveal something more. In the case there is no faction frigate on the initial warp-in, you can ignore the NPCs and simply activate the gate. A few moments after landing, you have a chance of being awarded the Escalation. The room behind the acceleration gate is indeed devoid of ships, with just a pair of empty warehouses. In the second encounter of the expedition, you will again land directly on an ancient acceleration gate guarded by a group of Serpentis NPCs. This group consists of up to 11 frigates and destroyers. If you're lucky, one of them will be a Shadow Serpentis frigate. Destroying the Shadow Serpentis NPC, or in its absence, taking the acceleration gate, has a small chance of escalating to the third encounter of the Angel Kickbacks expedition. Again, a similar setup, and this time you caught some bad guys in the act. Not that stealing from the Serpentis is necessarily bad. Now, if you only would find one of these hideouts where the angels still store some booty. Perhaps the next location will lead you to something more interesting. The room behind the acceleration gate will have a Gallente military station ruins, guarded by a group of up to 7 Serpentis NPCs. These ships can be ignored. In the third encounter of the expedition, you'll once again land directly on an acceleration gate guarded by a group of Serpentis NPCs. This group consists of up to 9 frigates and destroyers, several of which will be advanced frigates. If you're lucky, one of them will be a Shadow Serpentis frigate. Destroying the Shadow Serpentis NPC, or in its absence, taking the acceleration gate, has a chance of escalating to the fourth and final encounter of the Angel Kickbacks expedition. It's another hidden warehouse, and this time a stiffer resistance. There's one location left, and it should get interesting. Your computer grabs your attention, indicating that the route to the last location has been calculated. The final stage almost always sends you to a low security system. The room behind the acceleration gate has a large Minmatar commercial station ruins. Above it is a defunct Stargate, surrounded by a group of up to 10 Serpentis NPCs. These ships can be ignored. In the final encounter, you will land directly on an acceleration gate, which you must activate to enter the first room of the site. The Serpentis NPCs are split into two groups. The first group is on the left, near a bunker, consisting of 4 frigates. The second group is on the right, also near a bunker. This group consists of 3 advanced frigates and 3 destroyers. The advanced frigates may use warp disruptors, so you'll want to keep your distance and keep an eye on your directional scanner. The second room of the site has 2 groups of Serpentis NPCs. The first group is behind you to the left, consisting of 5 frigates. Among them is the Shadow Coreli antagonist. The second group is further behind on the right. This group consists of 5 frigates and a cruiser. Destroying the Shadow Coreli antagonist will prompt the closing message of the expedition. The ethics involved in robbing this hapless band of angels are interesting. Robbing from thieves who stole from drug dealers who sold their drugs to people who robbed someone to afford them. You wonder how long it has been since the valuables in your cargo hold were in honest hands. The Shadow Coreli antagonist may drop one or more Coreli A-type deadspace modules, or a Daredevil blueprint copy. You'll have to decide for yourself whether it's worth risking travel through low security space to run the final encounter. Other players will have to use combat probes to find you, and you'll be behind an acceleration gate once you're in the site. This should give you plenty of warning in the case someone is hunting you. A ship like the Ishgur, fit with railguns, is capable of running the Serpentis Lookout in about 4.5 minutes. For newer Gallente pilots, an Atron or Incursus fit with railguns can work as long as you keep moving and keep your distance from the mobs. Perhaps the best ships for this site might be tactical destroyers or the Orthrus. I actually consider the Ishgur to be highly suitable for this site, and for its expedition alike. While recording the footage for this video series, I kept track of the statistics for 15 Serpentis Lookout sites. Over this period, 5 of these sites spawned a Shadow Serpentis pirate, and 5 of them escalated to the Angel Kickbacks expedition. Of the 5 Shadow Serpentis NPCs that spawned in the Serpentis Lookout site itself, only 2 of these dropped the Shadow Serpentis module. Perhaps the bigger loot potential with this site comes with the Angel Kickbacks expedition. Because these can escalate up to 4 times, and each encounter has a good chance of spawning a Shadow Serpentis pirate, your odds of finding something valuable is quite high. The faction spawn is guaranteed if you make it to the final encounter. Through my 5 escalations, I had a total of 13 encounters. 11 of these had a faction spawn. I managed to loot 2 mid-grade Asklepian Epsilon implants, a Coreli A-Type small armor repair, a Coreli A-Type 5mn micro warp drive, and a Daredevil blueprint copy. While extremely rare, the best you can find is the mid-grade Asklepian Omega. Stay tuned to Riley Entertainment for more EVE Online combat site guides. In high-security Gallente space, you can also probe down other unrated sites like the Serpentis Hideout, Serpentis Watch, or Serpentis Vigil. Each of these has a similar chance of escalating to 4 stages of encounters, respectively called Mind Flood, Jet Set Hooligans, and Booster R&D. Some of my past work includes a complete Gallente Cosmos guide, and a blind playthrough of the Gallente Epic Arc in Anishkir. I also have an interest in amateur game development. Look for the Snake Game Dev Series on my channel, which led to the release of my first 2D game over on itch.io called Garden of Eating.